Hi guys, this is my first time going live, so I don't know if I'm really live or not, but this is a big hello to all of you and happy Valentine's Day. Questions are going to start rolling in. So.
Yes. So Preeti, what are your plans for Valentine's Day?
My plans for Valentine's Day, well, my first plan was to have this chat. So after that, I have to see how the day pans out. But I think I'm going to go out for a nice dinner, have a nice glass of wine, and then take a chill pill.
Let's talk about love. What do you feel about
love? Okay, 1 minute. I can see finally. Oh, hello. Amit Mishra says hi there. Hi, Amit. Maxwell Mahesh. What is this? Okay, lots of love. Hi, guys. So, since I'm doing this chat for the first time, I think we should go beyond just saying hi and hello. Otherwise, I keep saying hi, guys. Hello, guys. So, everyone who's watching out there, this is for all of you who are saying hi and hello. Hi. Hello. Good morning. Well, it's not really morning. It's afternoon now. So, good afternoon, everyone.
Khushi asks you, what's your next movie about?
Okay, Khushi, my next movie is called Bhaiyaji Superhit. It's action comedy. It's a very mad film. I think you can take your brains, but you'll have to laugh a lot. And it's just a really crazy story. I'm really excited about it because it's the first time I'm playing a role which is very earthy. Usually people always say that, oh, we have to cast Preeti in very Western roles. So it is a very, very Indian role. And I don't want to say much about it till you see the first poster out. Once the first poster is out, you'll know what the film is all about. But it's an action comedy and it is very crazy. And I'm looking forward to it.
So Geeta Rai says, I love you. You have been my favorite actress since I was 13 years old. I first saw you in the movie Dil Se. I'm your biggest fan. Everyone in my family knows how much I love you.
Thank you, Geeta Rai. I also love you since I was 13. And thank you. It's really sweet when I get all these kind of messages. And I love technology. I love Facebook because it's actually giving me an opportunity to talk to all of you. And it's quite awesome. I want to say this before I start answering more questions. We had a technology breakdown. The internet always works amazing here. And suddenly the internet crashed. The iPad ran out of power. And I had a bit of a panic attack because I like to be very punctual. But it's nice to be here. I wish I could see your faces out there so I could really see how you guys look like.
Dhananrad says, when will you visit Nagpur for promotion? You'll get a lot of plants here. Trust me, you'll love it.
I think I know who this Dhananraj is because I see him on Twitter. So if you're the same guy, hi. And I don't know when I'm going to come to Nagpur, but I hope soon. And this film's going to come out in the summer. So I'll be in and around Nagpur for sure.
Vinayak Verma says, when will your next movie get released? Who's the male leading actor?
Hi Vinayak. Well, my next movie is Bhaiyaji Superhit. It should release this summer, which is either May, April, May, June, one of those times, I think so. And there's Sunny Deol in it, there's Arshil Barsi, there's Shreyas Talpade, there's Misha. It's a big multi-starer. So that's it.
Arpan Mukherjee says, when are you coming to Kolkata again?
I've actually been a lot to Kolkata the past couple of months. But maybe I'll come for the film promotion and I'll definitely, hopefully, come for an IPL game. I just hope it's one of those cold evenings in Kolkata, not that hot and muggy because Kolkata is so hot. Bapre. But soon I hope.
Amir Mirani says, hi Preeti, which is the recent Bollywood project which has truly inspired you?
Hi Amir, true to your name, I'm going to say the project that really inspired me was Dangal. I loved Dangal. I love the fact that Amir did such an outstanding job. Those girls did such an outstanding job. And I think it's important films like these are made because it truly, you know, people get so influenced when they see movies. So it's really nice to see that it's a story about women, especially in a place in Haryana where there's so much, I'm sorry, I don't want to get all serious on you. But, you know, they have a lot of female infanticide and feticide. So it's nice to see that if you have daughters, they can be treated equal to your sons and they can bring as much as glory and as much as wealth into the family. So that way I love the movie. I also like the fact that, my God, Amir is such a perfectionist. I mean, he played from a 25-year-old to a 60-year-old. So, wow.
Ankita asks, when do I see you in Kapil Sharma show? And you're my favorite actress.
Hi Ankita, thank you. Now that's a question you need to ask Kapil, not me. But hopefully soon. I've been missing going to his show because I was traveling a lot. And then finally, I said, okay, I'm going to go to Kapil's show, because for 3 years they were calling me. And when finally I landed on the show, I found out that the show had changed and Kapil had moved to another channel. So I ended up on that other show, but hopefully soon.
Preeti, have you watched Kabil yet? And do you have any plans to work with Hrithik anytime soon? Ask Gagan Rana.
Well, hi Gagan Rana. Yes, I watched Kabil. I thought it was amazing. I told Hrithik, I mean, the other night we had dinner with him, so I told him, that after Koi Mil Gaya, I thought, obviously I love Koi Mil Gaya more, so I thought after Koi Mil Gaya it was his best performance, and it was a really well constructed film. And I don't know when I'm going to work with him more, but I do know that after I've done this film, Bhaiya Ji Super, I had a lot of fun shooting, so I am going to do more films for sure. Earlier I had said no to films completely, but now I'm going to do more. So maybe 1 a year or 2 a year if they don't stretch too much, but I'll definitely do more films. And who knows, I could we could do a film soon.
So Patricia asks from Canada, which role has been the most physically tasking for you in all these years?
Which role has been the most physically tasking? I think has to be Laksh, because we shot at 18,000 feet. Of course, Laksh is a film that's based on the war, so we had to go to real locations. So we went to this Khardungla Pass, which is like the highest motorable road in the world. We went there, and of course, I was playing a journalist, so I had to be like, hi, today this happened, that happened, da, 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 and I had to speak non-stop, and it was quite crazy because I couldn't breathe, and you have to acclimatize, but it was very tough. And hats off to all the women in the crew, because half, like a lot of the crew was grumbling and some people left, but all the women stood their ground and really did a great job. So I think physically that was the most taxing for me.
Reema asks, when are you coming to US and will you visit me?
But US is my home now. It's half my home is in Mumbai and the other half is in US. So I'm actually very soon. Coming to a mall near you. Depends where you stay. Sorry, it's a bit cheesy, but soon.
Mohammed Faraz says that you have a lot of fans in Pakistan. Please come to Pakistan. We all love you here.
Hi, Mohammed. Salaam alaikum and thank you. I would love to come to Pakistan. I tried. There were a couple of events which I was invited for, but then eventually it didn't work out. So I hope it happens. I would love to come there for sure.
Nora says, your movie Kya Kehna has truly inspired me and helped me grow up as a strong woman. Are you doing some more challenging roles like this in near future?
Hi Nora, thank you for the compliment. I hope it's not inspired you to have a in your teens. Sorry. But yes, it was my first film. I didn't know really what I was doing, but I did believe it was a story meant to be told, and I enjoyed doing it. So. Yes, I think I will do more challenging roles, though recently, a couple of years, I was doing these very serious roles because I just didn't want to be called bubbly anymore. But I think now I'm over that. So my new film, Bhaiya Ji Super Hit, is a little bit of a pataka and a bubbly role. But after that, if I see something interesting and see something that has a lot of substance and is intense, I'm going to do it.
So a lot of your fans say that they have been missing you on screen and they're very, very, very happy that you're alive today and talking to them.
Thank you. I'm also excited to be live. I just wish I could see your faces because I just feel I'm like talking into this blank space. But I can see the comments and I can see little hearts flying and little thumbs flying. So that's kind of cool. I wish I could see faces flying.
So,
Facebook, are you listening?
Mahendra says that I love your pairing with Shah Rukh Khan. Is there any possibility of you working with Shah Rukh any soon?
I don't know. Depends on the script really, you know, and depends on the film. So you never know, they say never. I think my pairing with Shah Rukh has been one of my best pairings, besides my pairing with Saif. I started my career with Shah Rukh. like, you know, from Dil Se to Kal Ho Na Ho to Veer Zara to, I don't know if I'm missing any other movie, but he's great to work with. So I hope there's something fun which would do justice to both of us, and I'm sure we'll do it.
So Aarti says that she loved your work at Lakme Fashion Week and she would love to see you more on Ramp.
Thank you, Aarti. I was very nervous about that walk. I was hoping somebody just dragged me down. It would have been more fun. But you know, usually when you walk these ramps, they have so many lights on your face. And I remember I used to love watching those videos where people are falling, you know, and it's like those funniest videos. But there's this inherent fear in you that what if I fall? But I think that Sanjukta Datta, she had a lovely, lovely sari. It wasn't a sari, it was called a... forgot what it was called. But a chador, something chador. And I thought it was really nice because it had two pieces to it. And I'm glad everything went out well. So, sure. I mean, who knows? I might be dragged next time on the ramp.
So, Lilis asked that you have traveled to Melbourne, Australia during the shoot of Salaam Namaste. Did you like the place?
Oh, I loved Melbourne. I shot in Melbourne for Soldier, my first movie. I mean, my second movie actually. And I shot for Salaam Namaste. I also shot for a South Indian film called Premante Dira. And I shot for another South film called Rajkumaradu. So, and all of them have done really well. So yes, I had a great time. And I think out of all my international crews, my Melbourne crew was like the coolest. Because every day we got a break or they said the weather was bad, they would just dive into the ocean and go surfing. So it was nice. And there were a lot of, they were fun crew. The only thing I remember that wasn't the greatest out there was it rained a lot. But I did get chuttis, I mean holidays. So let's see, you never know.
So Jasmine asked that what's your favorite music genre and which is your favorite song in the recent times?
Favorite music genre? I like all types of music except that crazy, noisy, I don't know what you call it, heavy metal or that dung, 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 dung. I don't like that at all. From classical music, which is Western, Indian, I like old rock, I like Hindi Bollywood music. I mean, my favorite right now is a song from my own film, Bhaiyaji Superhit, which is amazing, but I can't really talk about it right now. And the other favorite I have is from a film called Rangoon. It's called Ye Ishq Hai. Ye Ishq Hai. I like that. It's got a very soothing quality to it.
So after wedding, you have turned into a businesswoman. How has it been different from you being an actor? Asked Bishop.
Bishop, after wedding, I have not turned into a businesswoman. Before wedding, I turned into a businesswoman. After acting, I've come back into acting. I mean, after wedding, I've come back into acting. So I thought that, you know, maybe I should take a break from movies and focus a little bit more on business and get a little bit more... I wanted people to take me more seriously as an entrepreneur, but I guess I'll always be an actress and I can't change that. So now I want to balance both.
Ajit says, thanks for coming live. There are hardly few actresses who do so. Be simple as you are, Preeti.
Thank you, Ajit. It's nice to be live too and alive. So, thank you. And listen, guys, whoever's watching out here, and there are going to be some cheesy comments coming, so just so, bear, deal with it.
Annie asks, what is the funniest thing that has ever happened to you on a set?
Annie! I know this Annie. Annie is on my Twitter. So, hi, Annie. What's the funniest thing that's happened to me on a set? I recently did a... I don't know if you're going to get this humor, because it's a bit of it's Indian humor. But I recently went on the set and I was doing a commercial and the director came up to me and said, okay, now that everything is done, let's do some Chakravarti shots. And I was like, what's a Chakravarti shot? And he goes, a shot that comes anywhere, any place, anytime. So I said, okay, so how does it look like? And he was like, beauty shots. So I thought that was kind of weird. Because in my entire career, I've never heard of Chakravarti shot. So if there's a Chakravarti out there, maybe you can explain to me why it's called a Chakravarti shot. Sorry, I'm just trying to look if the air conditioning is working because it's kind of getting hot in here.
Share some of your memorable experiences in Dil Chahta.
Oh my... of all, I don't think people know this, but when I was asked, I actually auditioned for the, I didn't know if it was an audition, but I did a photo shoot for Dil Chahta Hai, where Mani sir and Mani sir called me to Madras, and he made me wear this black cloth around me, dupatta, and he said, look very serious and stuff. And when I'd gone to Madras, I was so hungry because I'd taken the flight had got delayed, I went to sleep in the flight, so I didn't really eat.
Yeah.
What happened? It's back? Sorry.
Yeah.
Technology, guys, it's not me, it's technology, I forgot the question you asked me. But anyway, now I'll just jump to, I think it was something to do with Dil Se. So, I remember when I was doing the scene, there was a scene in Dil Se where Shah Rukh and me are out for lunch, I'm eating this burger, and I tell him, aajkal ki lagya SKPS, and he goes, SKPS, and I say, haan, shaadi ke pehle sex, and then I ask him if he was a virgin. So Manisa walked up to me and he said, great rehearsal, but in the take, don't use the word sex. And I said, okay, so what do I say? So I asked Shah Rukh, I said, please help me, what do I say? And he's like, the whole day you talk non-stop, so just come up with something. And I was like, and I got really nervous because I didn't know what to say. So I sat there and I was shaking because I'd never acted before, I'd never done acting school, I'd never done any kind of, I didn't know what improv meant. So I just went, aajkal ki ladkiyan SKPS, and he said, SKPS? And I said, yeah, shaadi ke pehle, honka bonka bonk. I remember Shah Rukh almost fell off the chain, he went, honka what? And the whole crew started laughing. And I think that was like an icebreaker for me, and Mani sir was like, I just wanted to be yourself and just have fun. But, I mean, people think the song Jia Jale was like, oh, beautiful and pretty and all. But we used to get up at 4 a.m., drive, pata nahi where, like in Jhennum and back, and then, shoot all day, and then again drive to all parts of South India at night and reach there by 1 o'clock, go into these guest houses and stay, and then get up at 4 again. So, I didn't know what was happening in that film, to be honest. It was like I got hit by a train. So, only when I saw the film when it came out, I was like, oh my god, this is how films are made. So, it was quite an experience, and I'm so glad I did that film because it was such a big learning curve for me. And I must say this, I have a lot of friends in the industry. I think Shah Rukh is my friend, but I think more than a friend, he's been like a mentor because he taught me almost everything I know about how to stand, how to give dialogue delivery, how to pause in a scene, and I love him for that.
Okay, so Ishpita asks, what are the plans for IPL? Is there something new in the team we should look out for?
Yes. The new thing in IPL this year is we have Virender Sehwag, which is my favorite Viru. He has taken over cricket ops this year. And I'm sure all his dynamism that he has as a cricketer is going to come through our team. So he's going to be in the forefront for Kings 11 Punjab. And I'm really crossing my fingers. Because not only is he a great guy and he's a lot of fun, but he's a great cricketing mind. So I'm looking forward to a really good season this year for Kings 11 Punjab.
So Nikhil Yadav asks, which is your favorite food? Italian, Chinese, Punjabi, South Indian. What's your favorite cuisine?
Desi food, baby. My favorite food is kadhi chawal, parathe. I was going to eat some parathas, but there was so much disasters this morning, from internet crashing to no battery in the iPad, that the paratha is waiting for me. So after this chat, I'm going to eat one big aloo ka paratha. I like all kinds of food. I'm not really a red meat eater, but as long as it's yummy, bring it on. I'm my pet name is Preeti, always hungry Zinta. So all food is great.
So Faraz Ahmed asks, please share some inspirational word for today's youth. Everyone wants to get inspired.
I think Faraz Ahmed, that's a very interesting question. Inspirational words for today's youth is, I think for the women, I always say one thing, that don't tell me sky's the limit when you have footprints on the moon. So women all over the world should just go live their dream and do whatever they want, because it's possible. And I'm not saying this for women in first world countries, but more for women who have become forgotten women and don't have the opportunities they can. But besides that, and besides sounding very serious, I think today's generation has forgot how to really live. there are very few real friends you have. It's all internet friends. It's people always scrolling and looking at social media, which is great. I love social media because I'm here talking to you right now. But I think, to go out there and play in the ground, that how we used to do, it's so important. It's so important to have human contact. And for all the trolls out there, get a life. Sometimes I read all these comments and I'm like, oh my God. So all the people out there who are trolls, not because it's their job. If it's your job, then it's your job. I can't say anything about it because some people actually get paid to troll. But whenever you troll somebody, I hope you realize that you're a miserable person. Sorry, I'm saying this on Valentine, but I still love you. Happy Valentine.
So Anushka asks, how did you meet your husband?
Oh, Anushka, that's a million-dollar question. And he's here. I can see him on the corner of my eye. So how I met him? I met him in Santa Monica in Los Angeles about 6 years ago. And then we dated for 5 years, and then finally we got married. I'm not going to tell you the details.
Sneha Shah asks, you believe in true love? Question mark.
Of course. I don't know anybody who believes in fake love, but of course I believe in love. And yes, true love, to now you only find out after a couple of years, no? Nobody's one some big gyani who's going to say, yeah, true love is like this and all, and then you get munch. So I don't know about that, but yes, I do believe in love. And I think love only stays if respect goes hand in hand with love. And to all those women out there, when guys tell you they love you, and it's great, but if a guy tells you that if you want to prove your love to him, take one photo without any clothes and all, that's not true love, guys. That's kind of stupidity. And especially, I want to say this to all the youngsters out there, please be careful with all the stuff that you put on the internet, because it's there forever. It's not going to go. So be careful of that. Sorry, again, serious but relevant.
Krishnendu Menon asked, what's the secret of getting those dimples? I want them too.
Krishnendu Menon, first of all, I have one dimple. Ting, ting, ting. You can see. And the secret of it is, when I was a little kid, I fell off a train and then a little pebble went and got stuck in my cheek and it made a dimple. So, sorry, it's actually a muscle defect, and I got it from my father. He had two, I have one. So I hope when I have kids, at least this gets passed on. I really hope so.
Petan says, Preeti, you've inspired so many with your strength, courage, words and kindness. I want to thank you for being live and everything you have inspired me since I was 10 years old. I'd watch you while I was growing up in the hospital. You have helped me be brave, so thank you.
Petty, that's the sweetest thing ever, and words like these are what inspires me. And life is not always up, you know, we have downs too. And when I hear things like this, this is what kind of becomes my trampoline to jump out of things when I'm down. So thank you. Love is always not one way, it's both ways. So I do appreciate you sending me these awesome comments and keep sending them.
So Shrija asked that how has the industry changed since the time you have left it, and does it feel any different when you're coming back to it? Who's your recent times favorite actress?
How has the industry changed? Well, the industry has changed in a way, and in a way it hasn't. I do see that when we came into acting, we were like, I don't know, we were like so sweet and little chubby, and I didn't know how to do makeup, I didn't know how to act, I learned everything on set. Today's youngsters, when they come, they are all fully ready. They have done acting classes, they have six packs, they have perfect makeup. And so that way, the youngsters today are not raw. They are, they might not have acting experience, but they are completely ready to go there. That I think, and the other thing I think where it's changed is I do see a lot of management companies come in, which is also good in a way, and sometimes not so great depending on how the people react to them, because that's another difference. And the third thing is now the concept of hero heroine has changed. When I started my career, everyone used to tell me, madam, you need to be like a heroine, and I was like, okay, whatever. And I was never in the mold of an heroine. But today there is no thing called heroine. Today they're characters. So it's important if you're playing a character from Haryana that you sound like you're from Haryana and not from Bandra, you know. So that's another thing that's different. So people are focusing more on making it authentic. And who's my favorite actress from today? Among the younger lot, I love Alia because she's a cutie. And also I feel a little attached to her because in Sangharsh she played my mini-me. So her debut was with me, yours truly. So I do like her a lot and she's very talented. And I love, actually there are so many people doing great work. Vidya Balan does amazing work. Kangana has done really good work. Priyanka has done good work. So I think no actor is bigger than a role. So if you have an amazing role, you'll probably see actors just kind of flourish. So that's it. I hope I haven't left anyone out because there are a lot of talented people out there. And if I've left anybody out, I'm sorry. Okay. I can see Prince Zia Khan saying, "Oi, hi."
So what do you think, Preeti? Whose dimples are cuter, Shah Rukh's or yours?
Mine, of course.
Sandeep Raj.
I mean, you have to back your own self, right? Like, I do love Shah Rukh, but I love me more. And he's got greater dimples because they're two. I'm cuter, but there's one. Okay. And by the way, I have to tell you the story now that you're talking about dimples. I found out somebody called me and they said there was a picture of Shah Rukh and there's a picture of me in some doctor's office. And he said if you want dimples like these, he can create those dimples. So so somebody asked me if mine was created. I thought that was the strangest thing ever. But that's it. That was the story.
Sangeet Shukla says, any messages to the singles in the world on Valentine's Day? There are many.
Any messages to the singles is, yes, have fun out there till you're single. Don't compromise on a bad relationship and just get hooked up for the sake of hooking up. And I think if you wait and have your priorities right, you will find the right person. And play the field. If you're single, enjoy yourself. It's the best time of your life because once you're hooked, booked and cooked, then you're cooked. Nothing's going to happen then.
Rishabh,
I just got a dirty look from my husband out there.
Rishabh Bhatia says, sorry. Say something about Sanjay Leela Bhansali. Please share your views.
Something about Sanjay Leela Bhansali is he's a very good filmmaker. I think the way he shows Indian grandeur and the way he shows movies on that large scale and they're beautiful. And now he's gone on this whole historic vibe where he's making films. I think he's really good. He's a very talented filmmaker and I would love to work with him someday.
Okay, any last message for all your fans out there for Valentine's Day and about life in general?
Guys, my message to all of you is live and let live. Enjoy yourselves. Life is very short. Spend it on good things. Appreciate your parents. I think yesterday I just did this whole campaign, an advertising campaign, and the only reason I did it was in some ways it was for the forgotten woman, which was the mother. I mean, you know, there's so many times you tell your mother tells you, okay, what do you want to eat, and you're like, mom, just make me anything, and then you go to sit for breakfast or lunch or dinner and then anything is on the table and you're like, mom, why did you make this for me, and you fight with your mother. And our mother loves us unconditionally and we don't even appreciate. So I think it's important to appreciate your parents, especially your mother. And just live your life. Don't worry about what people say. Don't worry about people putting you in a box and saying you can't do this. If someone says you can't do it, it definitely means they can't do it. It does not mean you can't do it. So follow your heart, live your life, be happy and smile a lot. Okay. So I think now we've reached, we are reached the end. I'm going to press the finish button. So see you guys. I love you all. The finish button is coming.